Hi everyone, today I would like to present my final year project, Machine Learning for Money Laundering Detection. With the development of technology and the prevalence of global communications, detecting money laundering activities has become more drastic and challenging. Hence, there is an urgent need to design an effective money laundering detection system to help banks assess risks of potential money laundering activities. Money laundering refers to the procedures and actions used to legalize the illegal profits or funds through different approaches. Its purpose is to cover up the owner's identities to avoid inspection and potential charges by the authorities and integrate the money into the standard financial system. Money laundering activities generally involve three main stages: placement, layering, and integration. Representing integrating the illicit fund into the financial system, layering transactions to cover the origin and transferring it out for usage. In the past, money laundering detection is generally based on predefined rules, which are easy to code and understand. However, such a method requires rules to be revised frequently to incorporate new information. As technology advances, machine learning is widely adopted in the banking industry, but with a limited number of signals available. In this project, we hope to achieve the following two aspects. Firstly, we hope to conduct comprehensive coverage and analysis of the signs and parameters for machine learning models based on the typologies of money laundering. And secondly, to design a protocol to allow cooperation between banks in money laundering detection without breaching clients' confidentiality. By studying the typology of money laundering, we can better understand its nature and design effective strategies to address the problems. Criminal organizations generally use four main methods to launder money. Firstly, obscure identity. Secondly, abuse a store of money to avoid inspection. Thirdly, abuse a transfer of money to cover up the traces of money transfer. And lastly, use the loopholes in the jurisdiction system and regulation. We will construct signals based on the typologies. Firstly, single bank indicators. These are the indicators that can be calculated with the information held by an individual bank. And it falls under four main categories: customer identity, financial behavior, transaction behavior, and social network matrix. For more details about the signals, please refer to the report for more information. During this step, we transform the money laundering activities into quantifiable signals based on guidelines provided by law enforcement bodies, which can be used for machine learning models. As for the multi-band indicators construction, it is to deal with more prevalent cross-band and cross-border transactions nowadays. We will mainly analyze them from the social network role and transactions characteristic perspectives. These will be useful for the future transaction graph construction process mentioned next. Before we introduce our protocol, there are two important techniques. The first is homomorphic encryption. Homomorphic encryption is a form of encryption allowing one to perform calculations on encrypted data without decrypting it first. For example, if E is some homomorphic encryption method, mathematical operations on encrypted M1 and encrypted M2 will be the same as doing mathematical operations on M1 and M2 first and later encrypts the results. The second technique is secure multi-party computation. It is a method for parties to jointly compute a function over their inputs while keeping those inputs private. This allows participants to get results they require without knowing the information of other participants and help with privacy-preserving practices. Based on the techniques and signals, we want to propose a two-component money laundering detection framework. The single-band detection system is mainly in charge of the money laundering risk assessment, with the known data or limited sharing of information for cross-band transactions. It relies mostly on the indicators constructed in the previous section, using homomorphic encryption and calculation. The multi-band detection system is in charge of evidence collection and analysis from a more extensive network, which requires input from different bands in a secure and encrypted manner, which forms a criteria-based cluster and performs social network analysis to detect money laundering activities on a broader scale. These two components together will achieve a better performance in detecting money laundering activities. In conclusion, in this project, we have provided useful insights into establishing the money laundering detection framework. We have constructed comprehensive quantifiable indicators that each bank can calculate and use for its analysis. At the same time, we have proposed multi-bank indicators construction, which relies on the multi-party computation and homomorphic encryption techniques. Looking forward, we think that future work can be done in the following areas. Firstly, is to assess the time complexity of the approach suggested here. Secondly, a real-life application can be developed to test this framework with real data to assess its efficiency. Through this project, I have learned a lot and want to thank to Prof. N for his guidance throughout the journey. This is the end of the presentation. Thank you.